This is a delay line with 16 ports. It consists of a PCB track that is actually acting like a capacitor and with resistors between it. The total delay of the entire line is about 2 nanoseconds. So I have now a pulse that is 15 nanoseconds wide and a rise time of 2 nanoseconds, and the repeat time is 1 megahertz. So we're looking at the input and the output of the entire delay line here, with 2 digital signals and 2 analog signals on the input and the output of the delay line. Of course, the output of the delay line is attenuated a little bit because of all the resistors. Okay, let's zoom in a little bit on the rise time. This is where all the interesting things happens. So I'm running here in 2 nanoseconds per division. And this is the same as the 500 mega samples. The digital system is running on this scope. So yeah, that is one division. What you see here is a time dither. So it's almost like an alias in time, giving you a higher time resolution of the digital system because I'm triggering on the analog system. This is my homemade Logic Analyzer probe set that is actually available as a kit. The cable here is 1/2 meter long. So let's compare the performance to the original one. This is the original Logic Analyzer set from Siglent. It is called SPL2016, and it is really nice. It's also a little bit expensive, but it is really nice. It comes with release buttons, so when it clicks into the scope, it locks really nice and tight. And as you see, the connector system and the PCB and the fit and everything is exactly the same as the DIY model. There's also about 1/4 millimeter space all around this connector, exactly as my own. So the feel when you press it in and pull it out, and when you wiggle it a little bit around in the connector, it is really close to the same feel. Well, you could maybe argue about the ground wires. There are only 2 ground wires per set, but the signal wires, they are really nicely identified by color codes, and the connectors themselves, they are in a really good quality. There's a good feel when you work with them, so I'm really happy about that too. Let's look on the performance of the original probe set. As you see now, the digital signals, they are a lot more delayed. That means they're a lot more to the right. It's of course because the cable is a lot longer. This is 1 meter long compared to the 1/2 meter that I got. So what you have to do is click the digital setup, go into DSKU, and then simply dial in the delay of your cable set from 12.5 nanoseconds to 3.29, so that is 9.2 nanoseconds slower. Let's take 4 signals with 400 picoseconds of delay between them, and then let's do a little analysis on what's going on here. Now you see again, we have 2 nanoseconds per division, so it's clear that the center of the rise of each of the digital signals is about 400 picoseconds in between them, right? This is visible because the scope is acquiring quite a lot of curves or traces per second. And what you see here is a time dither of the changes. I am running the scope in the fastest possible hold-off time, so that means I will get as many curves as possible per second. Now, let's try and go into single. See, every time I push single, I get a new set of waveforms. And now, see the digital curves. And this is of course not a problem when you're running in normal speed logic. So we are really pushing it at the absolute maximum here.